is beautiful, white is beautiful. Eight beautiful women are contesting for the title of Miss Africa at the 6th annual Miss Africa Texas pageant.
This is a passion in my heart, and I just keep going, and this is the 6th year celebration of this event. And I keep going because I see what I do to these young ladies, and that's my motivation.
Defined by who I am and not by what they see.
Embrace your bare canvas. Understand that there shall never, nor now until the end of time, be a more beautiful piece of art to ever grace the face of the earth than you.
Luke 12:48 says, "For everyone who has been given much, much will be required." And to me, that means use your platform.
This life is too short to let other people degrade us.
Women empowerment. Once you empower a woman, you've given her the tool to succeed in life. Because when a woman is educated, she's more powerful than she ever thinks or imagines.
Energy, beautiful, just crit charisma.
I'm super excited, I'm pumped, and I can't even say more.
Entertainment for a lifetime, dancing, comedy.
Are you guys excited about the show?
Yeah.
I'm so honored to be here tonight, and I just wish all of the girls the best of luck.
I'm so thankful that you guys voted for me, and I'm so thankful that the judges voted for me. Thank you.
Judges, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one.
Educating Nigerian parents on the symptoms of pneumonia to their young ones. At 6 months, a baby, already crawling, active, agile,
lost his life to a deadly virus, which could have been prevented earlier on. This virus led to pneumonia. That baby was my brother. That baby was my parents' son. Pneumonia accounts for 15% of all deaths in the world for children under the age of 5 years. According to the World Health Organization, an estimate of 922,000 children died this year from pneumonia. As an African girl, a Nigerian to be specific, I've understood the condition of those around the world and in Nigeria who live on the streets unsheltered and who are there and don't understand the symptoms or what could cause their children to be dying. As an aspiring accountant, I've chosen to look into how much it takes to fund the antibiotics of those children who have pneumonia. And it takes about $109 million to care for these children. Slowly taking baby steps, I intend on gradually educating the parents of Nigerian children, telling them the symptoms of pneumonia, how this could be prevented, the dangers and the causes of pneumonia. If I am made Miss Africa Texas of 2015, I hope that I'm able to go school-wide and educate gradually in organizations all these people, hosting programs bit by bit for people to understand the dangers and ways to prevent 922,000 people in a year from dying. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, judges, contestant number two.
To be a college dropout. On paper, I'm scheduled to end up using drugs. On paper, I'm scheduled to end up in prison. Because I'm supposed to let my struggles supersede my abilities. But I'm here to prove that wrong. My situation does not define who I am. I define who I am. In Nkechi Amadi, and my platform is helping children of incarcerated parents. These children have a stigma on them. 70% of these 3 million children end up incarcerated themselves. These children suffer from low self-esteem, financial struggles, and low academic scores. As we all know, it takes a village to raise a child. So we must not label these children as at risk, but instead set them up for success. We have a program, a mentoring program, here in the DFW that caters to these children called Amachi. Amachi is a Nigerian Igbo word, meaning who knows what God has brought us through this child. If winning this pageant, I plan to partner with Amachi and introduce college tours and programs that give these children something to look forward to. I am passionate about this platform because I believe that these children can beat the odds, like me. I am now a junior at the University of Texas at Arlington, aspiring to be in pharmacy school. So I ask you, can I count on you not to count us out? Thank you.
Mastercraft on it, flavor.
Finally, oh, it's about to go down.
You know the money no be
poor. Finally, oh, it's about to go down. When my baby, oh, it's about to go down. All my sexy ladies, it's about to go down. When I get so okay,
judges, contestant number 3.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Wissama Ude. My platform is raising cancer awareness to African societies today. When it comes to cancer, most people don't understand how serious it really is. In 2008, I lost my aunt to a battle of non-Hodgkin lymphoma, which is a rare case of disease, which is a rare cancer that affects the lymphocytes, which interact with your immune system. So when I win Miss Africa Texas, I want to be able to give back to people. I want to be able to raise awareness to people how serious cancer is. Cancer has affected 68% of the population out of 56 million people within 2012. So when I win Miss Africa Texas pageant, I want to be able to raise awareness, get people more involved and also create a website to where they actually have more information about cancer. My name is Wissama Ude, and I'm your contestant number 3. Thank you. Gentlemen, my name is Emeza Odumri, and my platform is to bring awareness and build up self-confidence for women of color. As a woman of color, I know we face many stereotypes and obstacles that may seem unachievable because of our ethnic background. If I am crowned queen today, I will I will come together with organizations where we will bring together all women of color and help them see themselves in a positive image. I'm contestant number 4, and thank you for having me.
Gentlemen, judges, contestant number 5.
Talking about bullying in school for my platform. 1 in 3 students are a victim of bullying. Millions of kids go to school in fear due to the fact of being attacked and intimidated by other students. Bullying is the cause of self-consciousness, depression, and even suicide. Some parents think, it's okay, they'll get over it. No, it's not that easy. You know why? Because I was a victim of bullying. I came to the United States at the age of 7. I was so excited to be in the States. It was great until I came to school. School was horrible. I wondered, why are these kids making fun of my hair, making fun of my clothes, my accent, even my country? I didn't understand. Why was God punishing me was my question. But he wasn't. I met my best friend in middle school. She was also a victim of bullying. Together we raised each other up. We built each other up. And that's what I learned. You can't keep waiting for the world to change for you. You have to change for the world. If I win this contest, I want to start a club, not just any club that kids never want to go to. I want to start a club where kids can come together, victims of bullying can come together and feel safe, feel loved, feel comfortable, even make lifelong friends. Because this life is too short to let other people degrade us. My name is Nate Ezigwe, and I'm contestant number 5. Judges, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 6.
Hello. Hi. I'm gonna sit through the mic. Hi, how are you all doing? My name is Valentine Waithera. Just wanted to reassure you my name for maybe anybody who had come in who wasn't here before. My platform is education is the key to success. Knowledge is power. I began my journey when I was 17 years old. I was in Masai Mar in Kenya. And I was on vacation. My father took my family and I out to it was a lounge, and we met this man named John, or rather that's what he introduced himself to us, just kind of make it easy for the tourists. And he took us on a tour of his village. After going through the tour, at 17, I remember thinking to myself, how does this man speak such proficient English? And anybody who's been to Masai Mara, you know that that is the jungle, like literally wildebeest, lion. You'd be surprised whether it's Africa, Asia, Brazil, you name it, somebody in the jungle is greeting you. Hey, how are you doing? And I'm like, okay. So I asked him, how do you speak such proficient English? Where did you learn it? And he told me that he went to the school. Masais are nomads, if that is the correct term. They move around from, you know, kind of counties to counties, the jungle style. And he had gone up to standard 8, which is equivalent to grade 8 here or year 8 in Kenya. So I asked him, why did you not continue with your education? You seemed like you really wanted to learn. And he told me that, I wish I could, but I do not have the funds to go. And the next high school is kilometers away. By the time dusk comes, the lions are out, the elephants are out. Many of us have died out here who haven't gotten back in time to the village to be protected. So I remember on the plane I was crying, and I thought to myself, how can I help this man? Because I know he's not the only one. And it made me look at the opportunities that my mom, I always have to stop. My mom had given me coming from the shambas, the farms. And here I am, I've been to England, I'm in the United States. I can go to college. I'm 17, I'm in my mom's house. I have no job. And there's this man who doesn't have the opportunities that I have. So I was like, I'm gonna join a pageant. And the money they gave me, I'm gonna give it to him. First pageant, I didn't win. It's okay. But I practiced and my message got heard. 17, 18, 19, 20. I started college when I was 16. And at 20 years old, now I look at life and what I have learned is you're either the clog, you're in this lifetime, you're either the factory owner or you either are the mule who works in the factory. Let me explain that. Okay. You can be a doctor and hey, you went and you got your degree and congratulations, this is what you wanted to do in your life. But you're still not as free, because guess what, you have to clock in, and at some point in time, you start feeling like, I don't want to do this. I can tell you, I look at my mom, she's 50 now, she wanted to do nursing. If you look through her albums, her quotes are, I wish I had 1,000 words to help all these people. She wanted to be a nurse, but now it's, I don't want to do this. I love this, but I can't do this, so I started thinking to myself, I'm not gonna help somebody else be a mule in a factory. What else do I need to do? One of my mentors, or somebody who I consider a mentor, is here tonight, Mr. Kelechi, CEO of Big OB Productions, and he can tell you that I spend most of my time at the library. And through the last year, constantly reading, constantly trying to seek this knowledge of how do I attain as much money as I can, yet be free and teach it to other people. Something hit me 3 months ago, and I was like, you know what? I'll build the biggest library Kenya has ever seen, and I will make it accessible to every and anybody, and not just Kenya. I will start with my country, but to all other nations of Africa, and not just Africa, go to Asia, go to Europe, because there are people out here struggling to find education that is accessible. Many people have told me it's unrealistic, but hey, if I start with the hut with 20 bucks in Moranga, that's fine. But yeah, all in all. I'm glad you got to hear a chance to hear my message, because when that first pillar goes down, then you'll know exactly what I'm doing, and hopefully you'll be there to help me. So thank you.
fuck me kiss. Set you on top, set you on top.
Yeah, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, judges, contestant number 7.
She don't care about me, back home story hunting. All she wants in life is winners hunting. Saying to myself, me want this fight.
$150,000 Syrian refugees have declared asylum with European unions. Actually, 6.5 million people have been displaced. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Arnella, and I am a child of an immigrant. My platform for tonight will be on refugee awareness. Although my mother was not fleeing from a country of war, she still came to America with the same desires as these refugees. Unfortunately, unlike my mother, these refugees and aspiring immigrants cannot get across the borders. Attempts to reject these people and deny them entry speaks to a selfishness that disregards this country's known truth. America is a country of immigrants. We are filled with people of all walks. President Obama even issued a national call to every state to allow these refugees in. And only 31 states said no. So today, ladies and gentlemen, I'm standing before you, letting you know I'm making it my mission to reach out to these helpless refugees. I plan on starting petitions, and I plan on starting fundraising websites. I also plan on incorporating the things I love to fundraise for them, which is dancing. I plan on starting dance workshops as well. Ladies and gentlemen, as I stand before you, I just want you to understand my heart truly cries out to them. And I know these are just very few steps to helping them, but I can only do so little. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your patience. We really appreciate you. Are you having a great show tonight? Are you having a great show tonight? Sounds more like it. I'm just going to take a little bit of your time to introduce the queens, and we're going to get right to the crown, and that's the fun part, right? So our queens in the house, can you please come up on the stage right now? I see lots of crown and sashes in the crowd. Please, can you take a step forward to the stage for me? We do have our first ever Miss Africa Texas in the house, Merlin. All the queens in the house. We have Miss West America in the house as well. She was one of our contestants. Please give her a round of applause. Don't they look lovely? Isn't this beautiful? This was our past last year's winner. She's going to tell you what she's done so far. That was Miss 2013. That was our very first Miss Africa Texas, and that's Miss West Africa. Please give them a round of applause. Thank you so much. With that said, we're going to have a really quick performance. We have a performance by Bibish Ellet from Los Angeles, California. Thank you so much and have a great show.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number, I don't have a number. I don't look like a queen. Hello? Hello? Nasa, let me cook. Let me share the chop. Eh? How you all doing tonight? The queens are doing great, and I'm doing great too, and I'm sure everybody here is doing great. The judges are walking, and I'm ready to walk. The problem is I don't know if I'm going to walk my waist, my leg, my head, or my mouth. I'm shaking. I've never been amongst queens before, even though I'm a queen too. I've always been in my presence as a queen. Hello? Hi, Zoe. How you doing? Are you ready? Yeah.
The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run to it, and they are saved.
Ah, and I saw them with the attack person.
Thank you.
Oh,
I was ready to cry because me and my family were going through hell. But God has shame, put a big shame on the face of the devil while I was flying to Dallas. Because whosoever kill you, they will be caught. I mean it. Whosoever, I mean what I'm saying. I'm here because of Jennifer, and I'm not crying because of the faces that I see here today. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Celebrate because God is great.
Yeah, give it up, give it up, give it up, give it up for that auntie. It's not easy to dance and sing at the same time. Give it up for her. Oh, yes. Are you having a good time? I have a question for you all. How many people are graduating 2015 December? Make some noise. Only one. At least you're graduating. We thank God. I'm not saying graduating with one class remaining. You. You're graduating fully. Right? Confirm. It took me 15 years to graduate. 15 years. Back in the village, my father used to flog me. He used to, up that time, he would flog me and I would piss hot piss. Every time I would come 31st out of 32. Every time my father would be flogging me, flogging me, flogging me. One day I said, this thing is too much. You know what I did? I went and changed the results. I put second. I didn't want to put first. I didn't want to push up too much. So when I come home, I just came to my father. I gave him the result. He said, hey, Kelly, is this you? That is me. He started praising the Lord. One day, my father was wondering, how did this boy come second? Every time, this boy is coming second, second, second. My father went and bought a lie detector test. Not any type of lie detector test. This one a Niger lie detector test. So if you lie, the machine will slap you. Do you understand? So, finals day reached. I came. I brought my results. My father coming. Chukwuma, come here. I say, yes, dad. Where's your results? I say, daddy's here. Tell me your results. I say, daddy, I made second. The machine slapped me. Boom! He said, so you have been lying to me this whole time, eh? And you know African parents, they have to talk and beat you at the same time. This boy, you are very useless. I will kill you in this house. You're very useless. After all the tuition I paid for you, when I was your age, I used to come first. Immediately he said first, the machine slapped him. Toza! I looked at my father and I said, So I'm not the only one lying. So my mother came in and said, okay, let me use this opportunity. I said, daddy, have you cheated on my mother before? I heard a slap. Toza! Why do people laugh? You don't even know what happened. When my mother came in, nobody asked her. When I said, daddy, have you cheated on my father before? She opened her mouth and said, I will never do that to my husband. The machine now slapped her. Y'all ready to get this show started? We're gonna move into the next phase. We're gonna have the crowning phase. Y'all make some noise, make some noise, make some noise. Ginger.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to move it to the award portion of the evening.
And ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a look at our contestants one more time. Ladies, gentlemen, judges, hear your contestants one more time. Let's go, ladies. One by one, one by one, one by one, two by two, one by one, crowning moment. This is the part where nobody loves. Can you just encourage our contestants one more time with a scream, a shout, something funny? Thank you so much, thank you so much. Contestants, can you please take a step back for me? Thank you. DJ. DJ music, please.
There's no music.
Thank you. Got it. Thank you. Thank you. Let's welcome our CEO, Ms. Jennifer Tang. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for hanging on so late. We're going to do the crowning, and the judges, you guys have been awesome. You have a different eye from everyone else that's watching the show, and we respect your results. We have a winner. Well, and we have the top three. This is how it goes from here on. The girls all are winners. These are our top seven. So it's not only we only found seven girls, we found more girls. We got top seven because we had a busy show. We had to cut it down to top seven girls because we didn't need space wasters. I know we're here to encourage young girls, but we need young girls who are ready to take it on. So right now, we're going to award these girls for their wonderful services. And I'm going to ask for my little girl, Miss Bijou. Is she in the house still? Can you please come up stage? She's going to help me give awards to this. Can you give her a round of applause? Young talents. When I see a girl with so much confidence, you just know where she's gonna end tomorrow. She's very a strong little girl. Come on. So we do this to encourage these girls. Just being here, they are winners. So right now, we are going to present them with an award to say thank you for being a part of this amazing event. You're encouraging the girls like this to want to be like you when they grow up. So I'm going to have her hand these to you guys. Congratulations and thank you for being a part of this show. Please give them a round of applause. Okay. Thank you.
I need help. Somebody.
And that's because she has an amazing mom, and you can hear her in the crowd. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, ladies. At this point, the judges came up with a tally right here, and we have some queens. But before I introduce anything else, we have a voting system, meaning 2 weeks before the pageant, we have an online voting, and we have what we call the People's Choice Queen of each year. And this year, Miss Kechi Amadi, she was our winner. And she won this African Texas People's Choice 2015 with over 2,000 votes, online votes. So this also teaches young girls how to campaign, because she has to campaign for those votes, and she earned each and every one of those votes. So let's give her a round of applause. Ms. Kechi. You have to come forward for your crown. Ms. Kechi. Ms. Marilyn, you want to help me crown? And she also gets a crystal crown and a beautiful sash to go with that. Keep doing what you're doing. You're amazing. And her sash, please. Thank you. Thank you for being a part of this amazing event. And right now, we have Miss Africa Texas 2015, Miss Talent. Miss Talent 2015. I'm going to call on contestant Miss Nietzsche, you are our talent for tonight. Come on forward. Miss Veronica, can you help me present her? Okay.
Even if I cross the motion, you can't get a picture. Hey, before me, get ass is smoking cigar. I know you want me, it's mine, I'm not coming.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. She did an amazing job. Her job was very traditional. And she won the talents for tonight. At this point, we call on Miss Africa Texas Supermodel with Style. And this award is given to the lady that looks more like a supermodel. And we give this award because it helps her pursue her career in the future if she decides to go into modeling. And this goes to Miss Busama Ude. Ladies and gentlemen, can we give her a round of applause? And we're gonna have Miss Simone Davis present her with this wonderful award. Congratulations and thank you for being a part of this amazing event. Miss Humanitarian goes to the person that has the heart of giving. Pretty much a heart to carry on a platform that will encourage a lot of people around the world. And we give this award to Miss Valentine. Ladies and gentlemen, can we give her a round of applause, please? Miss Humanitarian. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Africa Texas 2010 is going to present her award. Miss Congeniality is going to Miss Amazi. Ladies and gentlemen, this lady, she knows how to get her way through any situation. And we present her with Miss Congeniality because she just knows how to make people feel better and laugh. And it doesn't matter what she's going through in her life. Even through the competition, she finds a way through anything with so much ease. And she has such a poise. Let's give her a round of applause. Miss Photogenic, who else? If you've looked at our website, you've looked at our Facebook, Miss Rachel, can you please come forward and take your award? Miss Photogenic 2015, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm going to have Miss Africa Texas 2015 to present her with that. Can we give her a round of applause? Isn't she beautiful? They're all pretty. She won Miss Photogenic. And now, the judges. At this point, I do not do this part. I give it on. For the top three, this is very emotional to me because I've got to know these girls and they're all amazing. It's hard to pick three girls out of this amazing crowd. So I'm gonna pass it on to my amazing MC, and I'm out.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up one more time for our contestants tonight. I am so scared. Ladies, take a deep breath. Can we get a drum roll? So our top three for the Miss Africa Texas pageant tonight, in any order, this is not in the winning order because we still have the question and answer segment coming up. Our first on here will be contestant number one. Ladies, are you ready? Next up is contestant number seven. And lastly, we have contestant number two.
Ladies, can you fill up?
So we're going to have questions from our judges. Judges, we have contestant number one, number seven, and number two. So to ask the question, you can call a contestant number and ask a question.
Good evening. Congratulations on making top three. Contestant number two, how do you see yourself 15 years from now?
Can you please repeat the question?
Contestant number two, how do you see yourself 15 years from now?
Thank you so much for that question. That is something that actually comes across my mind many times in a day. 15 years from now, I see myself working as a pharmacist, married, and having a family of my own. Thank you.
Next question.
Good evening, ladies. You all look very beautiful and you worked very hard, so I think you all deserve a crown. But my question is gonna be for contestant number seven. Who is the most influential person in your life?
Do I know about that? Okay, that's easy. It's my mom. Every day, watching her wake up, stand on her feet to work hard for me, honestly pushes me to become a better person, not just for me, but for her. And I do all of it just for her, so that's my mom. Thank you for that question.
Next question, please.
Contestant number one, if you had to live your life again, what part of your life would you change?
Thank you very much. I believe if I had to live my life again, I would not change anything in my life. That is just because change is very constant, and no matter how much we try to make things better, we will always fall. And when you fall, the key is to just get up. Get up and do something better. So I wouldn't change anything, because in the future, I will still make a mistake and I will be proud of myself because I will get up. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, our top three, can you please take a step back with the rest of the contestants while we tally up the votes? And right now, we're going to introduce our last queen. I'm sure she's sad to give up her crown. She's going to do her final walk and tell us what she's done throughout the year. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Simone Davis.
Everything they say the time's supposed to heal, but I am done with my dream. I'm in California dreaming of that who we must be when we were young and free. I've forgotten how it felt before the world fell at our feet. There's such a difference between us.
Hello from the other side.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I first and foremost want to give honor to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It has been a long journey, but it's been a prosperous journey because I was able to find the businesswoman within. I always try to tell everyone that when you go for a crown, don't go for the glitz and the glamour. Go because you want to change the world. I definitely want to give honor to my family, my mom, my dad, my stepmom, my auntie, my friends, my church family, because they were able to teach me how to humble myself so I can make an impact, a quiet impact, but an impact. I also want to give thanks to Miss Jennifer. She's an awesome mother. She's an awesome mentor, an awesome CEO. And most importantly, I'm standing up here because last year I stood on this stage and I declared that my platform, Dancing for a Better Youth, would be turned into a nonprofit organization, and it has. And that's my home. I drew that symbol, and the name of my nonprofit organization is called Princess Encouraged in the Kingdom, and the acronym would be PINK, P-E-N-K. You can also find us on www.pinkprincess.org. This organization is not, when I first started out on stage last year, it was supposed to be for the youth, but I realized that the youth are a future you, and we are a present youth, so we all need to come together so that we can change the world and make it a better place. So I have some little candy bags that I want to give everybody. It has my business card attached to it. Like I said, this organization is not just for youth. It's for school-age children. It's for undergraduate young adults in college. And it's also for our professional women. So it's a way for us to encourage our community. Our slogan is striving to build a connection through Christ with the cleansed outlet vessel. This way so that we can cleanse ourselves internally and be able to reflect positive vibes into our community. So I'm just so humble, and I just thank God because it's only Him that I'm standing here today with my own nonprofit organization. We are located in Fort Worth. We're located in Plano. We also have a branch in Dallas, Texas. And if you know a young child, if you know an undergraduate who's in college, or if you know a professional woman who wants to be a part of this organization, please get my business card. It does not have the website on there, but like I said again, the website is PINK, P-E-N-K, Princess, PINKPrincess.org. And these little favors will have my business cards attached to them, and I did make them with love. I made them myself, so I definitely took my time and did that for you guys. And I just say, y'all be blessed and make sure that y'all make an impact in the world and encourage your child.
Is making to her community. She has done such an amazing job all of last year. I saw her at every event talking and encouraging young people and just being a motivational speaker and the inspiration that the world needs to see. So I'm very excited to do this every year. I'm really excited because it also inspires me as well. Contestant, can you please move forward? Ladies and gentlemen, this is a very hard path. This is very difficult for everyone, the judges. Everything was very close. So, with that said, drum roll please. Before we get to the scores, we do have some prizes for our contestants, for our top three. This is from Audacious Jenny. We have makeup for you ladies, and this is by Audacious Jenny. Can we give a round of applause for Audacious Jenny? Drum roll. Our second runner-up
is contestant number 7. So can we have our top twos come closer, please? So this is the sad part. But the bad news is, after tallying a vote, it was a tie. So we're going to have the judges ask the top two one last question. We can't, it was a tie, we don't know what to do, so we need to make sure that we're crowning who deserves to win tonight. Are we okay? Can we give a round of applause for our contestants? Let's encourage them one more time. Great. So we're going to have our judges. We just need two judges to ask contestant number 1 and contestant number 2 one last question. And we can go from there.
Contestant number 1, why should we choose you?
Unmute one.
Can we please repeat that question?
Okay, contestant number 1, why should you be selected tonight?
Thank you very much. As impromptu as that is, I feel that I should be chosen as Miss Africa Texas 2015 because I have the passion to move forward. I have the passion to achieve things, and I have the passion to be great. So whatever happens right now determines the future and determines how I'm going to pace myself in the future and what I'm going to achieve in gaining my platform. Thank you.
Contestant number 2, why should we choose you as the Queen of Miss Africa 2015?
Thank you so much for that question. I believe that I should be the queen today because it took me a long time to get here. It took me a long time to realize that I deserved to be here. I hope to encourage and motivate children who feel as though they are faced against odds. I hope to encourage children to think that they deserve better. So that's why I feel that I should be the queen tonight. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Let's take a moment. We'll be right back. Can we have Kelly? While the judges are deliberating, can we have some light music? Thank you.
So how from the other side?
This has been really hard for everyone. This has been very hard. You can see we're really struggling here. And after great deliberation, and the things that the contestants have done, and we've tallied up all their votes for tonight, the talent, the evening wear, what they've done to get here, and all the voting tallied up, can we get a drum roll to crown our queen tonight? But they do get a scholarship because it's a scholarship pageant to help them with their school tuition. Can we get a drum roll, please? So with great deliberation tonight, considering all the things that the contestants have done to get here, including their talent, their evening gown, the questions and answers, and their voting, our queen tonight is...
beautiful, why it is beautiful, eight beautiful women are contesting for the title of Miss Africa at the 6th annual Miss Africa Texas pageant.
This is a passion in my heart, and I just keep going, and this is the 6th year celebration of this event. And I keep going because I see what I do with these young ladies, and that's my motivation.
Embrace your bare canvas. Understand that there shall never, nor now until the end of time, be a more beautiful piece of art to ever grace the face of the earth than you.
Says, for everyone who has been given much, much will be required. And to me, that means use your platform.
This life is too short to let other people degrade us.
Empowerment. Once you empower a woman, you've given her the tool to succeed in life. Because when a woman is educated, she's more powerful than she ever thinks or imagines.
I'm super excited, I'm pumped, and I can't even say more.
Entertainment for a lifetime. Dancing, comedy.
Are you guys excited about the show?
Yeah.
I'm so honored to be here tonight, and I just wish all of the girls the best of luck.
I'm so thankful that you guys voted for me, and I'm so thankful that the judges voted for me. Thank you.